A strict custody agreement, hefty child support payments, and Tom Cruise's deliberate choice not to see his daughter. You won't believe what Suri's relationship with her dad is like now. Like a lot of expectant parents, Tom Cruise was ecstatic about the impending arrival of his third child, Suri. In fact, he was so excited about Suri that he reportedly bought his own ultrasound machine so that he could see her every day. Cruise told Barbara Walters about the purchase, which can cost up to $200,000. He seemed to understand that the purchase was on the lavish end, as he reassured people that the machine would be donated to a hospital after Katie Holmes gave birth. However, not everyone thought it was a great idea. In fact, the American Institute of Ultrasound and Medicine issued a statement condemning the act, noting that the buy bordered on abusing the equipment. Tom Cruise and Katie Holmes welcomed Suri on April 18, 2006. From all accounts, Suri's arrival into the world was fairly extraordinary. In fact, only a few days after her birth, Cruise described the experience on 2020 and still seemed in awe of everything he witnessed. He said, "It was everything that we wanted it to be. It was spiritual. It was powerful. It was indescribable."
Yeah, she's amazing. Magical.
CBS News noted that Suri weighed 7 pounds 7 ounces and clocked in at 20 inches long. A representative for Cruise and Holmes also shared information about her name, noting that Suri has Hebrew origins and can mean princess, as well as Persian roots, which could give her name the meaning red rose. In 2004, a then-engaged Katie Holmes admitted to 17 that she had once fantasized about marrying Tom Cruise. Fast forward a few years, and Holmes found herself walking away from the very marriage she once wanted. From all appearances, Cruise and daughter Suri had a solid parent-child relationship up until 2012. That was the year that Holmes filed for divorce in a move that apparently surprised Cruise. While speaking to German TV network ProSieben, he admitted that he didn't see the divorce coming at all, saying, "I didn't expect it. Life is a tragicomedy. You need to have a sense of humor." While Tom Cruise and Katie Holmes have been pretty quiet when it comes to the exact hows and whys of their divorce, when pushed, Cruise definitely let something slip. One of the big reasons Holmes reportedly said she wanted a divorce was to protect their daughter, Suri, from Cruise's religion, Scientology. The admission came out during his deposition during a libel lawsuit he filed against the tabloid. When asked if Holmes felt she had to protect Suri by leaving the relationship, he first replied that the question was offensive, explaining, "There is no need to protect my daughter from my religion." Did she say that? That was one of the assertions, yes. Cruise also admitted that Suri was no longer a practicing member of the religion. It's unclear if Suri has since been declared a suppressive person in the eyes of the Church of Scientology. Generally, suppressive people are cut off from family members and friends that are still active members of Scientology. Tom Cruise and Katie Holmes hammered out the details of their divorce settlement in 11 days, which is pretty remarkable. Cruise was not awarded custody of their daughter, Suri, at all, and instead walked away from the discussions with visitation rights only. In fact, Cruise was told he can visit with Suri up to 10 days a month, according to Us Weekly. Cruise also committed to a fairly hefty sum for child support, and TMZ reported that he pays over $33,000 a month for Suri's care. Cruise is also in charge of covering any necessary expenses Suri might rack up, including medical and dental insurance, schooling, and college. And he also apparently funds extracurricular activities. Even though the custody agreement struck between Tom Cruise and Katie Holmes makes it clear that he can see their daughter, it seems like he hasn't been able to make that happen. A source apparently close to the situation told Us Weekly that this seems to be a deliberate choice that Cruise is making, explaining, "Every person is allowed to see their child if they wanted to. He chooses not to because he is not a Scientologist." Outspoken critic of Scientology, Tony Ortega, spoke to Us Weekly about what might be going on behind closed doors, explaining that it's possible Holmes signed a document agreeing not to speak badly of the religion in order to get full custody. Ortega added that Holmes only had one objective, saying she wanted to get away and she wanted to get Suri. Things only got messier for Tom Cruise in the year after his divorce was finalized. In 2013, he admitted that he hadn't seen his youngest child for at least 100 days, explaining that his prolonged absence was due to his filming schedule. According to People, Cruise said in a deposition hearing for his lawsuit against Bauer Publishing that the then 7-year-old seemed just fine without him. Cruise added, "I also find that, you know, Suri is a very happy child and confident and has a good sense of herself." He further explained that, though he missed Suri's first day of school, that was because his daughter didn't ask him to be there herself. In 2016, InTouch Weekly reported that Tom Cruise had not seen or exchanged words with Suri in over 2.5 years. A source allegedly close to the situation told the publication that the pair had been using video chat and text messaging to stay in touch, but that it had slowed down, before adding, "He uses his film commitments as an excuse, but the truth is that doesn't hold much weight with Suri anymore." While it's unclear when Cruise will ever reconnect with his daughter, assuming the reports about their estrangement are true, the path getting to this point has been long and quite confusing. Perhaps the two will grow closer when Suri is an adult. Check out one of our newest videos right here! Plus, even more List videos about your favorite celebs are coming soon! Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.